morning, everybody. It is travel day. Stay tuned. Campground. We purchased the 1000 Trails Pass right before the COVID thing, so we've never used it. But since Big Daddy is not back at work yet, we're going to use this one that's closer to our kids, spend some time with them, and get some medical annual stuff done that's closer to our doctors. So packing up today, I'm going to test out the rack in the bathroom, and for those of you that didn't see previous videos, I'll show you now. I used to have this whole sink covered with all of these things, well, pretty much all of these things right here. So I purchased this rack, which is like a corner rack that you would put in the shower. We have all of our toiletries on it. I have a good picture that I'll insert. Of it, and we're gonna test it out today. I mean, the shelves are tall, you know, pretty tall. I don't think anything can topple out, but we'll keep the toilet seat close just in case. I have already got the bedroom done. And I know a lot of you have already seen this, but for the newer subscribers, what we do in the bedroom, everything here is museum glued down and can't move. This is locked. Everything on the bed. This is our grandson's bed, and we put this under our bed just at the end here. So I just put that underneath, and everything else stays. And I just have to unplug the electric cords, and I have them up there on the bed. And of course, nothing goes anywhere here. Oh, I do have to take this down because this is heavy, and I don't want it to pull that off the wall. And last time I forgot to shut this purple shampoo, so I had a purple shower base. We'll never forget that again. I tell you, if you make a mistake, it's the one thing you'll never forget to do the next time. Okay, so that's done. And then the last thing that I have to move is my little nightlight. And that goes right here with the washcloth. It's very hard to do with one hand. Hold on. There we go. And the toilet paper I put behind the toilet so it can't roll around. It generally sits right here. Hugs, you ready to go for a ride? Huh? You ready to go to a new place? Smell new things? They love travel. They, and let's shut the bathroom door. We're done with the bathroom. Yeah, they love checking out new places. Now they're getting into that. And the living room, pretty much done. I take down all the knickknacks that I have that can fall, and they all go in this mesh laundry basket, which is tied to this chair. I used to put them in this ottoman right here, but that's got my crock pot and stuff in it, so I decided just to use my portable laundry hamper. Big Daddy's basket, which generally sits next to his chair. My basket usually sits next to mine, but they will get in the way of the slide. This is just something I use to wash the dogs in and keep Abel's toys in. We're taking his car seat because he may very well come stay with us. And the last thing I gotta do is put up this fan, lock the television, and take down the Wi-Fi. Hey, Big Daddy.
Hey,
what's up?
Can I get the checklist?
Certainly. We have checklists for inside and outside, and we always
always look at these before we leave.
There's yours. Oh, and there's that other stuff we wanted.
Mm. All right, I'm going to start breakfast. And that way we have a full belly before we go.
I'm going to make some breakfast. This campground's only about an hour and a half from here, so we can't check in until 1 o'clock. It is 10:15. We don't have to be there at 1 o'clock, so yesterday, little backstory. Yesterday, Big Daddy went to put the motorcycle in the back of the truck. So we have a lot of friends in Beaufort that we used to ride with because we had a motorcycle group over there. So we're hoping to go around and visit everybody while we're there. Haven't seen them in a couple of years. Went to put the bike in the back of the truck and the battery died in the truck. The lift system pulls on the battery. It has a big pull, and Big Daddy thinks that it just, you know, killed it. So he charged it back up overnight. It was fully charged this morning, but it is the original battery in the truck. It's a 2016, so it's 4 years old, and we've been running on it for 2 years. It wasn't a brand new truck to us 4 years ago. We got it 2 years ago. So he went and got a much bigger, heavier duty battery this morning because we don't have any problems with that. Hopefully we won't. And so he's a little delayed outside because he was messing with that until it was almost dark last night, and then it started raining. It wasn't a good evening, but you know, these things happen. You just have to go with the flow. So hopefully today will be uneventful, but we shall see, and we'll take you along. I'll see you in a little while. Leaving home base on our way to Beaufort. So we will catch up with you guys when we get there and show you our first 1,000 trails. We just fed the dogs and they are ready to do their walking. Big Daddy has them. I'm following with the bag.
Yeah. And they're ready to drop a deuce.
We're waiting on them to do something, but they're so excited about all the new smells. Nothing's happening. Anyway, we took a wrong turn, but I think we found the path now.
Come on, John.
To the lakes.
Come on, baby.
And I had seen this on a previous video, introducing this 1,000 trails, which is the Oaks at Point South. And this isn't Beaufort. This is Yemassee?
This is Yemassee.
I think it's Yemassee. We'll double check the actual location, but it's very close to Beaufort. And they said this pond is filled with algae, which I completely agree with. But there's another one around the corner that people fish out of. But it's a lovely trail. The dogs are enjoying all the new smells so much that Big Daddy only takes 1 foot at a time. And if I zoom in back there, you can see the campground. So we are very close to the ponds. I will turn this off now, and when we get to the next one, I will turn the camera back on. In the algae section, which is going to break loose very soon and turn into, let me zoom in, the clear water where Big Daddy will be fishing. And that carries on all the way back here. As you can see, it's clearing up. This is pretty. This is very pretty. If the grandkids come over with their fishing poles, they'll enjoy this. I'm hoping that Nolan and Conrad will come visit with their daddy, our son, and possibly spend the night and have some fun and learn what camping is all about. But isn't that pretty? Our son came over with our grandsons, two oldest grandsons, and we had dinner, and they played basketball, and we went over a big long walk around the lakes and took some lovely pictures. So I'm going to insert all those now. Decided we are going to go to Tybee Island, Georgia, and have lunch at the Crab Shack because we love it there. And it's where the elite eat in their bare feet. So we'll take you along. It's a lot of fun. You can feed gators, and they have great food, and it's a fantastic atmosphere. So we'll see you at the Crab Shack. I'm gonna go do the birds. One of my favorite parts of the Crab Shack is coming to visit all the birds. Hello there. His name is Gilbert. Hi, Gilbert. This is Lovebirds, Lilo and Stitch. You want to say hey, guys? Lovebirds, Poppy and Peony. This is Blizzard. What are you doing? You sleeping? And there's Parakeets, Gilligan and Ginger. Oh, there you are. Down at the bottom. This is Sasha. I don't know them all. It actually tells you up here. I'm just letting you know. This is Michael. Hello, Michael. And who do we have here? My name is Diego. Hello, Diego. Do not put your fingers in the... Y'all bite? Cheeky things. And this is Hansel and Gretel. I remember you guys from before. Yes, I do. Let's see. Your captain. Wow. You are a big bird. Yes, you are. No wonder you have a name like Captain, huh? And this is Doobie. And here we have Boo and Poco. Poco has the orange or the yellow head, and Boo does not. Hello, Boo. Over here we have Baby and Otis. Hi, Baby and Otis. Oh, yes. I have one of those, the bell fell off. I know, you got lots to say. And this is Cece. Hi, Cece. All right. That's the birds. Let's go find Big Daddy. Oh, we're gonna feed gators.
Well, you said you wanted to feed them gators.
I do.
You can't.
Big Daddy's turn. There's a whole slew of them at the other end. You got it. Let's see what else they got down here. You think that's what it said? Oh, there's some over here too. I'm looking. Ugh. It's pretty. Yeah. Monkey see, monkey do. Be nice right for there. Gators and
three right there. Four. One over there.
Oh, a little tiny one.